When working with individuals, what are some of the steps that you take to prepare and some of the tools or components needed for you to carry out your work?
Yeah. Some folks are just find me on the internet, you know, or are recommended to me. Most of my work is referral. We have a conversation. We have a little counsel first, you know, do you know what I do? This is how I work. This is what we're going to look at. This is what we're going to plug into. And most folks, even if they don't have a huge exposure to alternative methods and ways and sacred work, you know, they're open. They embrace it. And, you know, I haven't had a lot of problems with that, you know. There's a little bit of investigation through conversation on where they're at. And I don't ever want anybody to be uncomfortable. It's okay to stretch them. That's good. But we never want them to feel like they're so freaked out or in danger energetically, you know, because some of these treatments can be either subtle or incredibly profound. You don't know how they're going to roll with it exactly, so it is a huge act of trust, you know, that their spirit brought them to you because they feel you have an element for them, you know, towards their path of healing and wholeness. And so you got to trust that. You know, I trust that. Same with ceremony. I trust that who shows up is supposed to be there. That's it. Their spirit brought them to it. Yeah.
For you, though, when you prepare for a ritual or a healing session, is there anything that you do personally to get yourself ready, or after the ceremony or ritual or healing is done, anything you do?
Yeah, that's a personal question, Marilyn. Personal. Sure, there's preparation. I usually go through a little time of asking what medicines need to show up, and it's kind of an intuitive internal inquiry, and what does this person need? You know, what am I going to need? What element am I going to need? And like that. And as far as preparing for the ceremonies, especially the bigger ones, I mean, you know, I've been doing Sweat Lodge for so long, you know, it's just kind of natural movement for me. I like to crawl in that lodge and sit down with some folks, and I love that. Love it. But Long Dance, you know, it does. It takes months of preparation for Long Dance. What am I going to say? What do the people need to hear? How am I going to be? Spirit, what do you want me to do? I gotta say, sometimes I'm out of panic, you know, because spirit just is not gonna clue me in until the moment. But, you do the best you can, you know. I really follow the understanding that I'm a hollow bone and that I'm in service. And, you know, we call those that are in service dog soldiers, those that are selfless. They're doing it strictly to serve the people and uplift the people, their village, whatever it is for them. And, I'm a dog soldier, old one. And so you just, you know, trust. It's a trusting process. And hope you do the best you can do with all that you know. And make sure that compassion is forward, you know, for all the people. Sometimes these processes, you know, kind of crash and burn people, kind of open them up, and, you know, they start processing like that, and you got to have compassion for that. And tolerance for everybody. Everybody. And I'm really blessed with a lot of folks that love me and support me and making my days a lot easier, you know, in ceremony. You know, they're old-timers of these ceremonies as well, and I'm not alone. It isn't just me. Yeah.
How has your own experience of ritual changed or evolved over the years?
There's a lot more folks. There's a lot more people coming to ceremony. Back in the day, it was all kind of secret. You know, kind of secret, just inside of a certain tribal community, and you know, it was just kind of secret.
Yeah. Oh yeah, we're gonna have a sweat. Oh,
have a sweat or like that, and you know, I think now that there seems to be a boldness out there now, and we seem to have permission now to do it in society. I've got to say, there are other groups of folks, pagan folks out there that still feel they have to be in a deep wood to do their ceremony because of misunderstanding. But, you know, I think there is more available. It's more available to the people, and we're, all the social networking, the Facebooks and all like that, you know, I try to minimize that, but it is an effective tool to connect to our community, which don't just live in our backyards. I mean, they live everywhere. And so we're finding that to be an effective tool, a gently used tool that we're using. So, yeah. It's changing all the time, and I think that our populations are just going to explode. We just did the Mexica New Year with the Tonoleki, the Kapuli Tonoleki, which is a Azteca Mexica dance troupe here, dance circle community. It's a large community, and we just did a ceremony, the Mexica New Year's, and oh my God, there were like over 400 dancers, and I'm looking forward to the YouTube films that are going to come out around it. It's just extraordinary to look at this circle with 400 dancers, and those 400 dancers went and practiced every week, sometimes twice a week, year round. And they all come together from Michigan, from Mexico, from Mexico, from this way, and all four directions. They come and show up, over 400 dancers, and they all know the dances. And they all know the dances. And it's just the long-feathered people. It's so gorgeous and beautiful. These long feather, all the regalia, it's just amazing. In sync, in harmony, in movement together. Birthing their new year, my new year, which is in this system, it's Reed 12. And, you know, it's just extraordinary to be a part of that community and to be in that movement with everybody. And then the public showing up massively. You know, some pretty hardcore looking dudes showing up, you know, and they're going, oh, that's good, you know. And the little ones. Just being there, the babies, loving it. You know, this year, you know, we just met, I met the little one, he was 2 months old. He was, she was pregnant at Long Dance last year in Sweat Lodge, in that circle. And I got to meet that little one today. It was, I must say, it was the highlight of my day. And all like that, you know. So I think a lot of folks are showing up. They're wanting more. They're wanting to check out their indigenous roots, you know. And I think that, you know, in Native ceremony, you know, there's a lot of whites in our ceremony. A lot of white people with that European descent heritage, you know. And, you know, I look at my white sisters and I said, you can own this. Not all Native systems agree with that. But where I stand, I figure that that sister has the same history as I do. You know? They have the same decimation of their culture and that movement. And, you know, I don't see age in this time. You know, I see ancientness, and we all have the same histories, you know, and we're all here to, and our prophecies say that. We're all here. We're all back. We're in many colors. Yeah.
Yeah, I wanted to ask you about that because it seems that people with little or no Native North American blood ancestry sometimes feel that participating in ceremony can be disrespectful.
Mm-hmm. Yes, yes, there's a lot of guilt, and especially my white sisters when, you know, and I don't placate that guilt. I don't. It isn't the sins of the father or whatever, how you want to put it. You know, I see the ancientness in their eyes. I see their inner connection to their lineage and their past lives and all that they are. They are so much more. You are so much more than this little bag of bones. No. Way back to where you're connected to the Great Spirit. And that's what I want to, and I hope that I achieve that. I think I achieve that. Warmness and welcomeness of honoring everybody. Don't making them less. They're not less because their skin is white or green. You're not less. And we're equal. Let's meet. Let's meet here in this sacred space. Lend your energy. Come and lend your energy to this new paradigm. I don't follow strict lines that are established out there. I don't. I'm very eclectic. I like everybody. They have a beautiful smile on their face and a warm heart, and they come with good intention. That's what you need. You know, come to me with integrity and good intention, and I'll treat you the same. That's it, right? Doesn't matter. But there is value in reconnection to your root and knowing your history of this lifetime. There is value in that. I'm not saying don't study that. Go back. See where your earth peoples dwelt and how their practices were. And it's wonderful. The old ancient dramatic practices and the druidic practices and all those things. Wonderful, wonderful, wonderful. I could relate. We can all relate. We can all come together as one. It's okay. It's okay to join into a red path ceremony. You know, if I'm leading it, it's okay. But I see sun dances. I see all these ceremonies all over, really opening up to everybody and really acknowledging that everybody is getting called to this. And they were born here on this Turtle Island. There's deep heritage here. Get to know that. It's okay.